Greetings from the Themerex team. In this video, we are going to talk about what is Elementor Flexbox Container, why use Elementor Flexbox Container, how to use Elementor Flexbox Container. We'll create a header and footer. So, what is Elementor Flexbox Container? Elementor Flexbox Containers are the way Elementor now organizes and lays out web pages. Elementor Flexbox Containers are Elementor's implementation of the CSS Flexbox model in their page builder. CSS Flexbox, or Flexible Box Layout, is a new web layout powered by CSS 3. From now on, all Elementor websites will have the Flexbox containers as the default building block for layouts instead of the old traditional sections and columns. Why use Elementor Flexbox Container? Create more optimized layouts. With Elementor Flexbox Container, you can set content direction, items alignment, justify content, etc., which will replace sections, columns, and intersections in old Elementor sections. Better web page performance, Flexbox Container reduces the number of columns and intersections while creating nested layouts by removing redundant inner div containers and then aligning items using Flexbox CSS. Those removed divs will decrease the page code, which will increase your page loading speed and performance. More responsiveness. All those options will help you to change the user experience based on the device viewport. How to enable Elementor Flex Container. Head up to Settings under Elementor in your WP dashboard. Now click on Features from the top menu. Scroll down to the Flexbox Container option and set it to active. Then scroll to the end of the page and save changes. How to use Elementor Flexbox Container. Now, open any Elementor page with the Edit with Elementor button, and you will be able to see the container element in the Elementor Editor panel. You can drag and drop it to the editing area, or just click on it, and it will be added to your editing area. Or you can scroll down to the bottom of the page, click on the plus button, select your container type, and it will be added to the editing area. How to convert Elementor section to Elementor Flex Container element. So what will happen to your existing Elementor sections? Don't worry, Elementor released an option to convert sections to a new Flexbox container with just one click. Head up to Section Settings, and here you will find the Convert button. Once you click on this button, a copy of the container containing widgets will be created underneath the section. Also, you can find the same settings in Page Settings that will help you convert all sections on the page to Elementor Flexbox containers. How to create header with Elementor Flexbox Container. From the WordPress website dashboard, click on Templates and then click on Theme Builder. Now click on Header from the left menu, and then click on Add New from the top. Click on this X button, and now we are going to add a container to our editor. So we are going to select this two-column container, and it will be added to our editor. So at first, we are going to change the background color of our container. So we are going to select the container, and then click on the style, and then for the background type, we are going to set it to classic, and we are going to select a solid color. For this tutorial, I will go with black. As you can see, the background color of our container is now changed, and we are going to add elements to our container. So from the top, we are going to click on this cube icon, and first, we are going to add a button to our container. We are going to search for the button and drag it to our container. So we need two buttons for our header. So I'm going to duplicate this button, just right, click on it, and then click on duplicate. Now we are going to change the text for our buttons. Just click on the button and it will be selected. Now on the left menu, you will see a text tab, and from here we are going to replace this existing text with our own text. I will change the text for both the buttons. And as you can see, the text is now changed for both the buttons, and now we are going to align these buttons so we can select a container. And here under the container settings, you will see the direction tab. So we are going to set the direction to row horizontal, and from the justify content section, we will select the end option. And then from the align item section, we are going to select center. So our buttons are now looking good, and now we are going to add other elements to our header. Again, click on this cube icon. Now at first we are going to add a site logo to our header, so we will drag and drop it to the editor. I need a different logo instead of this one, so I'm going to click on Change Site Logo, click Choose Image now. Select Media Library if your logo is already uploaded to the Media Library, select your logo, and then click on Select again. Now if you want to update the page, just click on Update. Click on this back button from the top, and then click on this X button. So our logo is now changed. And now we're going to add our navigational menu to our header. So we're going to drag this WordPress menu to our editor. And after that, we are going to change the container direction. We're going to change it to a row horizontal. And we can justify our container content. We can set it to start and or center. You can play with these options and choose the one that best suits your header design. But I will go with this one space between. With the help of the container, you can also set the custom height for your header. I will set 70 pixels for my header, which I think looks good. After that, we will do some responsiveness settings for our header. So we're going to click on this responsive mode button from the bottom. At first, we will go with tablet mode. And as you can see, our header looks good on the tablet. So we will do some settings for the phone header. So we'll click on this phone icon. Our header is not looking good on the phone, so we will change it. At first, we are going to change the direction of our first container, so we are going to select it. And for the direction, we will set the column vertical, and now it's looking good. We will do some settings for the buttons, so we will select the buttons container. And from the justify content, we will select center. And now our buttons are also looking good. So our header is now looking good on all the devices, and now we are going to publish this header, and we will display this header on all the pages. So we will click on the Publish button, and then click on Add Condition. And from here, we will select the entire website, and then click on Save and Close. And now if we visit our website, our new header is added to our website instead of our old header. Now let's see how we can create a footer with the Elementor Flexbox container. Again, from the WordPress website dashboard, click on Templates, and then click on Theme Builder. Click on Footer from the left menu, and then click on Add New. Click on this X button. Scroll down to the bottom, and then click on this plus icon. We are going to create a four-column footer for our website. We will select a four-column structure from here. In the first container, we will add our website logo and a little brief about our website. In the second container, we are going to add our navigational menu. In the third container, we are going to add our social media platforms. And in the fourth column, we will add our contact US details. But first, we are going to change the background color of our main container. Click on Style, select Background Type to Classic, and then for the background color, we will select a solid black color. and we are going to add elements to our containers. First, we're going to add our site logo, click on this cube icon, and then drag and drop the side logo to the container. Now we are going to add a short brief for our website. Click on the cube icon again, and drag and drop the text editor to the container. First, we are going to change the color of our text. Therefore, click on this text editor, then style, and then click on text color. We will set it to white. And now we will add elements to our second container. Click on the icon again and drag and drop the heading to the second container. We will change the heading text. I will set it to useful links. And after that, we will change the color of our heading. Just click on style and then click on the color picker next to the text color and we will set it to white. Let's change its size to 18. And after that, we will drag and drop our WordPress menu to the second container. We will set the layout from horizontal to vertical. And then we will change the color of our menu. Click on the style, and then click on the color picker next to the text color option, and we will also set the menu color to white. And for the pointer, we will set it to none. Click on content from the top, click on the drop-down next to the pointer, and select none. Good, we're done with the second container, and now we will move to the third container. Themerex Themes has a separate shortcode for social links, but we will show you how to use the Elementor version. At first, we are going to copy this useful links heading and paste it into the third container, and we will change its text to follow us. Now click on the cube icon again. Search for the icon list and drag and drop it to the third container. First, we will change the text color. From the top, click on the style, and then click on text after that. Just click on this color picker, and from here we will select white. And now we will change these list items to our social media platforms. At first, we are going to add Facebook. Let's select list item 1. We will change its text to Facebook, and to change its icon, just hover over it and then click on Icon Library. Search for Facebook, select the icon, and then click on Insert. As you can see, that Facebook icon is now added, and now we'll do the same for the other list items. We will select the second one and change its text to Instagram. After that, click on the Icon Library, search for Instagram. Select the icon, and then click on Insert. For the third list item, we will change the text to Twitter. Click on the icon library search for Twitter, select the logo, and click on Insert. And for the fourth list item, we will change the text to LinkedIn. Click on Icon Library Search for LinkedIn, select the logo, and click on Insert. So overall, the social media platforms are now added, and now we are going to change the icons to white. From the top, click on Style, and then click on Color Picker next to Color, and we will set the color to white. And after that, we will add a little bit gap between our text and icons. Now to add vertical space between these social media platforms, click on the list, and from the space between you can add your own custom space. And now we will move to the fourth column. We will copy this follow us text, paste it in the fourth container, and change it to contact us. After that, we will copy this social media icons list and then paste it into the fourth container. And now we will change its text and icons. We will select the first one, Facebook, and we will add our address here and search for the location icon. Select the icon and click on Insert. And for the second list item, we will change its text to our phone number. We will search for the phone icon and insert it. And for the third list item, we will change the text to our email. And for the icon, we will search for an envelope and add it to our page. After that, we will delete the fourth icon list item. Now, our Contact Us section is completed, and we will do some other settings for our footer. As you can see, our navigational menu in the second container is not looking good, and also it is not aligned nicely. We will change its setting a little bit, just select it and then go to Style, and then we will set the horizontal padding to 0. After that, we will also set the vertical padding to 10. And as you can see now, it's looking good. Let's also align our logo to the left. Now we will add padding to our container from the top and also from the bottom. So we will select our container and then go to the Advanced tab, uncheck Link Values Together, and add set 50 padding from the top and 50 from the bottom. There's very little space between our first container and our second container. We will give the first container a little bit of padding. We will select the container and then go to the Advanced tab, uncheck Link Values Together, and add 40 padding from the right side. Great! Our footer is now completed and looks good. Now we are going to publish this footer and set it to display on the entire website. Just click on the Publish button, then click on Add Conditions, select the entire website, and then click on Save and Close. And now if I go to my website, as you can see currently, we have a simple footer. But if I refresh my website, you will see the footer that we have just created, and I think it's looking much better than the previous one. That's it for today. Thanks for watching. Please like the video and subscribe to our channel for more useful tutorials. See you soon.